Morning, friends. It's always nice to address young people like you. I don't know my good days. Okay, so I'm going to be talking about hospitality industry as such, career options which are available, and tourism industry and hospitality. So before starting, I just want to have a brief understanding about your background. All of you people are from sales and marketing background. You people are doing your MBA? Second year?
Yes, sir.
So all of you have been exposed to internship, I believe.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So one very important question. How many of you want to join hotels, hospitality? I want to take hospitality or tourism as a career. So very few. Okay. So my focus today is going to be that by the time I finish, I convert almost 90%. To join hotels, hospitality, tourism. So hospitality traditionally was only restricted to hotels or the restaurants that come to our mind when we talk about hospitality or we talk about tourism. Things that come to our mind is, okay, it could be related to something related to hotels or something related to restaurants. But it's grown. It's grown over 10 years. There's been a lot of transformation in the industry. The industry has grown immensely. Can anyone of you tell me what all comes under hospitality apart from hotels and restaurants? What all can you think of?
Tourism.
Hospitality is a broad field. There are many industries that fall under tourism and hospitality. So a hospitality graduate, I'll let me put it across the other way. A hospitality graduate has many options now. Okay, I graduated almost 7 years back. That time there were only options of joining hotels or joining a restaurant. So that was almost 17-18 years back. Okay, and now there are many options. If somebody is going doing a hotel management, or somebody is an MBA graduate, he's got many options. He or she has many options apart from hotels, which are equally good options. And there is growth. The working environment is very good. The positives about hotels, hospitality is immense growth. Okay, it's the largest growing industry right now, not only in India, but the entire world. It is one of the largest employers in the country right now, as we talk. And I'm only talking about direct employment, okay, but hospitality creates lots of indirect employment, because if I'm running a hotel, I have 400 employees on board, okay, but apart from that, I have vendors who are supplying me goods. So that's how I create indirect employment as well. A hotel creates lots and lots of employment. Okay, a very, very, very important thing which I want to put across. Okay, there are two options how I want to deliver my lecture. One would be what I want to tell you guys, okay, that's going to be when there are no questions from that side. Okay, second option is what you guys want to know. So that can only be possible if you people ask me questions. Okay, where you people are sitting right now, I was there almost 15, 16 years back. So I have grown over these years, so I might talk something which will not make sense. So it'll be good if I talk what you want to listen. So that is only possible if you ask me questions. Okay, let me go back to my first question. What you guys think hospitality or tourism is all about? What are the options you think a hospitality graduate has right now? Options as career options once he comes out of the market. Okay, let's just start from there. Apart from hotels and restaurants, what do you think? Other options are hotel graduate, hotel management graduate, or MBA graduate has in hospitality or tourism sector.
Sir,
maybe
a survey
pursuing
many other industry
options
which are related to hospitality, whether it can be even hospitals.
Yeah, hospitals. Yes, hospitals are coming up in a very, very big way. Okay, there are luxury hospitals like Vedanta, Fortis, Max. Okay, they are picking up people from hotel management background and they pay you really, really well. Okay, any more?
Airlines are there, F&B companies are there.
Airlines are there, F&B companies are primarily restaurants.
So, like,
movie theaters,
yes. PVR cinemas, movie theaters.
Retail chains.
Retail, luxury retail, yes. What else? What else? Gentlemen in white? What else?
Sir, in hospitals also we can see that there are
Okay, let me tell you. Anything which has got customer interface, okay, has to deal with hospitality. Anything which has to deal with, which has a customer interface. Customers are the consumers. Okay, if I talk your language, sales and marketing. Okay, customers are the consumers. Okay, and consumers are buying a product, okay, for the product value, no doubt, but also for an experience. Okay, and the experience is created by hospitality. I am going for, say for example, I am going shopping, if I take retail. I am going to buy a product, but why would I go to a mall to buy the product when I can get it around the corner in one of the shops? I go to the mall for an experience. It is not only the experience which I get there, the environment is good, okay, it's an air conditioned. And also I get the assurance of the quality. So it all is retail, luxury retail. So the experience which is being, which is related to the product, it is all, it is the hospitality part of it. So it's hospitality. So no more hospitality or tourism is restricted to hotels and restaurants only. So it could be luxury retails, it could be hospitals, it is BPOs, KPOs, okay, it is airlines, it's even banking sectors, even banks they want people from hotel management background, they pick up people from hotels. And real estate is also very actively now getting into picking up people from hotels. They are all, if you see one thing common in all these industries, is that they all are selling a product but backed with experience. So wherever there is an interface between the customer, between the people, you would need hospitality. You need the hospitality part of it. And in hospitality, the prime job for any individual who's been hired from the hospitality background or to that kind of to do a job which is related to hospitality, his job primarily would be to make sure the customer is happy. So be it during selling or be it the after sales service, okay. And now the happy customers are more in, they want customers to be delighted, because exceeded, the expectations have to be exceeded because the competition is so stiff. The competition has become so intense, so stiff that you need to make sure the customers who are coming and shopping with you or the patients who are coming to the hospital. Not only the patients are taken care of, it is their family members also. So that again is part of hospitality. Even like nobody would have even thought that hospitals can become so hospitable. Somebody is going there for getting cured, okay, because of some serious illness, somebody is getting admitted. But the way they're taken care of, they want to go back there again and again. Hospitality is all about brand creation by, you want repeat customers. You want repeat customers, and that would be only if the customers go happy. Okay, that would be only, if they go happy, there will be a lot of word of mouth publicity, which is almost free of cost. There is no cost involved to that. So this all entails hospitality. No more hotels and retail or events only. Okay. So what are the two challenges what you think the industry is facing right now? Okay, one challenge is there which every industry right now is facing because of the economic slowdown which the country is also experiencing and the world is also going through. There is a drop in the revenues. Okay, revenues have shrunk. That is one challenge the industry is facing. The second challenge which the hospitality industry currently is facing as we talk is NESs. Anybody? Any guesses? What are the challenges you think the hospitality industry is facing? One, as I said, is the economic slowdown. Okay, we're not getting the revenues. What the hotels used to make or any establishment used to make, say, 4 or 5 years back. The second challenge is the quality manpower. So we're not getting the quality manpower. So that means there is immense demand of quality people in the industry. Okay, and like any other industry, the entry, as he also shared in the media, the entry is at the entry level is the down below that you guys start. Okay, but the growth is again, growth is immense because at every level there is scarcity. So you will see that you need to develop certain skills and you are ready to take on next position. And it could be as soon as even 8 months, 8 months to a year, you rise up to the next level. And then the next level. So as you go up the hierarchy, your the pressure on your mounts, okay, the pressure is immense. Pressure to deliver, because in hotels, now I just take the hotels per se, in hotels, there you don't get a second chance, okay, to please a guest. Either he's happy or he's unhappy. There is no gray area whether he's in between happy or unhappy. Either he's happy or he's unhappy. So you get one chance to deliver, okay, and there is no error for any kind of mistakes. So pressure is immense. Okay, three important things that you need to be in the industry. Okay, it is knowledge, skill, and attitude. Okay, out of these three things, attitude is the most important. Knowledge is the least important. Knowledge is only required, the technical skills are only required if you want to be a cook, you want to be a chef, you want to cook in dishes. Otherwise, because the industry is such that you're dealing with human beings, your customers are humans, your employees are humans, your vendors are humans. So it is 90% of common sense and 10% of skills. Skills, one thing which you keep on gathering as you are working in the industry, as you spend more time in the industry, you keep on gathering the skills and you get ready for the next level. So there are primarily four departments in hotel operations. Okay, the first one is front office. Front office is dealing with guests in the lobby. It is more about rooms. The second department is food beverage service, which entails the restaurants. Okay, which is the restaurants which are there in the hotels. Third is housekeeping, which takes care of the maintenance of the hotel. Could be rooms or public areas comprised of restaurants, lobby, even your gym, fitness centers, spas, okay, that all comes under. The maintenance part comes under housekeeping, and the fourth one is kitchens that cooks the food. Okay, so hotel as whole offers variety of products. Rooms, one of them, okay, that constitutes primarily 50% of the hotel's revenue. So this has come down. Over the years, there's been a lot of changes in the hotel business. Because of the slowdown, because of more local people, disposable income growing within the country, there are more people, they want to come out and dine in hotels. Okay, so hotels have started focusing more on food and beverage also now. Earlier the F&B part used to be neglected. So the focus is equal between restaurants and rooms. So you get good food and 50% of the revenue now comes from the restaurant part, and 50% of the rooms. Okay, so these are the four major departments which I spoke about. It's front office, it's food and beverage service, it is food production, and it is housekeeping. Okay, so people from your background, they generally join front office or they join sales and marketing. Sales and marketing does not come under the operations part, okay, but that constitutes the, I would say, the most important department of the hotel is sales and marketing, because that's getting the revenues to the hotel. So sales and marketing, in the entry level is you enter as sales executive or you can get through as a management training. Okay, management training would be a 1 year program, then after a year you become an assistant manager and you have certain targets to meet. So it could be rooms and food beverage. That again target depends on the hotel that you join, okay, and the market scenario, which is going prevailing market scenario. So it varies. So yeah, that's about hotels. I need some questions from you people now. Something that you people want to ask.
So what are the compensation structures with, I mean, for the management trainees?
Management trainees, it starts somewhere around 25 to 30,000 rupees a month. And depends on the hotel also, the property also. So it goes up to 35 to 40,000. The perks of the job is that you're working in a centrally air-conditioned environment. Your food and your uniform is taken care of. You don't have to bother about food and uniform. And in certain cases, even the pickup and drop is given by the hotels. Anything else? No more questions? Yes, you can get in as you can enter front office department, which is the lobby area. You can get in as front office assistants. And then you work your way out there. And the hierarchy of hotels is pretty flat. It is not too many levels. So the growth is fast. The growth is fast. And every level you climb, your salary almost gets doubled. So you get 100% hike every level. Working hours, it's a 24-hour industry. Okay, hotels are open for 24 hours, so you will be working in shifts. So it is only 8 to 9 hours.
Sir, what that one of my friends had the next lecture, so he used to work 12 hours.
Which department was he working in?
Sir, in service, like, he was...
Food and beverage service is generally, it's a break shift because the restaurant gets sharp in the afternoon hours. So you come for the lunch operation and then you come for dinner operation. So it really helps. Then again, 9 to 10 hours.
HR is the same
like any other HR department of any other company. Just that over here we are dealing with the people is from different background. Okay, there's a very diverse background of people that we deal with in hotels. Okay, clients from kitchen stewarding who's washing the windows, you are hotel services, going up to a chief security officer who knows most of the time is from our professional background. So the dealing is diverse, but it's a normal basic HR option. HR means you need to be understand the compliances and the job statutory compliances and normal HR options, not much. Thank you.